The first series of tests was conducted in San Diego Bay. All tests were conducted between October 1955 and January 1956. To better demonstrate spray characteristics at low speeds, this particular operation was filmed at 64 pictures per second, and directional control is maintained using water rudder, aileron, and asymmetric power. Banking the airplane with aileron and water rudder is the easiest and most natural way to maneuver. The procedure is similar to speedboat maneuvering. On this 180-degree turn into a crosswind, water can be seen entering the inlet ducts. Extended taxiing at this speed range in crosswind conditions causes a salt buildup in the compressor section, which produces a decay in thrust. A freshwater injection system was developed and is now on the airplane. This new system successfully purges the compressor section of the salt deposits, correcting the thrust decay problem. On this series of runs, fixed elevator positions from 15 degrees down to 10 degrees up were used. This run was made with a 5-degree down elevator into the wind. Takeoff time following afterburner light off was 28 seconds. This run, 10 degrees down elevator out of the wind. Takeoff time, 27 seconds. Here, the pilot is using a stick not fixed technique, but holding trim attitude in the fixed stick unstable region. Takeoff times were 25.5 and 28 seconds, with takeoff distances of approximately 2,300 feet. A total of 21 takeoffs of this type were made without difficulty. These two takeoffs and landings were made with a 90-degree 16-knot crosswind. The wing low crosswind correction method was used to hold the desired heading. Takeoff time from afterburner firing to liftoff was approximately 27 seconds. This landing was made at 14.7 feet per second sink with maximum oleo load of 42,200 pounds. The Sea Dart is designed for a maximum oleo load of 88,000 pounds. Following the sheltered water tests, operations were moved to the open sea 4 miles off the Southern California coast. The landing was made parallel to the major swell pattern and approximately 90 degrees to surface winds. Touchdown speed was 115 knots indicated airspeed. Landing and runout were routine. At speeds below ski emergence, bow spray is deflected down and out by the bow spray rails. When the ski emerges, the leading edge of the ski breaks the water surface with little disturbance, and as the speed is increased, the general spray pattern moves aft. For the takeoff, a technique was developed for optimum spray control. This involved heading the Sea Dart directly into the wind for ski emergence, firing the afterburners, and then making a sharp 90-degree turn to the desired takeoff heading. Liftoff was made in 26 seconds from afterburner light-off. Following the takeoff, a normal 360-degree pattern was made for a touch-and-go run. Landing loads were similar in magnitude to those encountered in calm water at a sink speed of 11 to 13 feet per second. Afterburners were fired at approximately 80 knots indicated airspeed during the landing runout. Operation in this open sea condition was considered routine. The second open sea operation was conducted in a sea state 5. Primary swells of 6 feet were running at 70 to 100 foot intervals. Secondary swells of 2 feet were imposed upon the major pattern, and every seventh swell was between 8 and 10 feet in height. One 12-foot swell was observed immediately before landing. The landing was made parallel to the major swell and approximately 90 degrees to the surface winds. The water conditions were very severe and far beyond that anticipated in the operational concepts of the design. This entire operation was filmed at 64 pictures per second, which slows down the action of the sea and gives an impression of calmness where such a condition does not exist. Although an operation in such heavy seas is not one that a pilot would care to endure as a daily task, the operation was considered successful and should influence future design considerations. On the takeoff parallel to the running sea, excessive up elevators were held, which retarded longitudinal acceleration. This caused a series of premature liftoffs, and heavy impact loads were experienced in the skipping that followed. Structural integrity, in spite of the severe pounding, was not impaired. Final separation from the water was made 40 seconds following the afterburner light-off. Although the pilot reported the landing was within the operating limits of the airplane, the takeoff run probably approached the limit takeoff capabilities of the airplane for the existing thrust-to-weight ratio. The final landing of the United States Navy's experimental Sea Dart on the waters of San Diego Bay was made without incident. The landing concluded hydrodynamic testing of the XF-2Y1 single-ski airplane.